Hello everyone. So today we are going to talk about how to find volume using cross sections. So many times when you will do some problems, you might come across the surfaces. You don't know the surface, but what you will know is you will know the cross section of the surface. And if you know the cross section of the surface, then the question is, how do you find the volume of that surface? If you have such a scenario where you don't know the surface but you know the cross section, then in that case this method is a very useful method. So we will see how single integration help us to find the volumes. Well, there are double and triple integration to find the volumes, but many times even single integration help us to find the volumes when we only know the cross sections. So what does the method says? So in this video I'm not going to prove this formula. It requires Riemann sum and all other things. But what my aim is, or what my goal is, to do around 5 to 6 examples so that you should be able to solve the examples using this method. So what does the method says? So as soon as you have some surface, what you do is you see what is the cross section of that surface with the plane. So if you, the plane is perpendicular to x-axis or the plane is perpendicular to y-axis. One can generalize this to horizontal and vertical lines, but let's restrict ourselves to standard horizontal and vertical lines, which are nothing but the x-axis and the y-axis. So if you have the planes, or if you draw the planes perpendicular to x and the y-axis, see what cross sections you are having. And once you have the cross sections, you find the area of that cross section. And once you find the area, you simply integrate that area. What you get is the volume. So that's a very nice method which tells you how to find the volume using cross sections. So if you are dropping the pin perpendicular to x-axis, this is the formula. If you are dropping the pin perpendicular to y-axis, this is the formula. Now let's take some examples which will help you to understand this method. So let's take the simplest example. So let's take first couple of examples to be a very simple one. So suppose if I take the first example as, so what is the scenario? I won't write the whole question. Let me tell you the scenario. So this is my xy plane. So suppose this is my y equal to 1 line and this is my y equal to minus 1 line. Suppose this is from say 0 to whatever, say 0 to 5. Now what is the scenario? The scenario is whenever I am dropping the plane perpendicular to x-axis. So if I take a plane, so if this is my plane and if this is the plane, whenever I am dropping the plane perpendicular to x-axis, what are the cross sections? The cross sections are nothing but the circles. They are the circles of radius 1. So this will be my radius. So wherever you draw the perpendicular, wherever you draw the plane perpendicular to the x-axis, what you are getting is, you are getting nothing but the, you are getting nothing but the circles, and all of them are the circles of same radius. So this is what you are getting. Can you imagine the surface for this? The surface is nothing but this cylinder. It's a small cylinder. It's the toy of my daughter. I hope I don't spoil this. So this is the surface you are getting. You can visualize this. How? So if I drop a plane perpendicular to x-axis, if I drop a plane perpendicular to x-axis, what will happen is, so this is what I'm getting. So I'm dropping the plane perpendicular to x-axis. So this is the intersection, this part. So what will be the intersection? Intersection is nothing but this disk. So this is the plane. I'm dropping it perpendicular to x-axis, and what is the intersection? Intersection is nothing but this disk. And if you observe, wherever I drop the plane, I will get, so suppose I'm dropping the plane over here, I'm getting the same cross sections. That means all of the cross sections are same. All of them are giving me the circles or the disk of same radius. So that's why I told you I'm getting the cross sections of same radius. So whenever you have such a scenario, so what is the scenario? Whenever you are dropping the pin perpendicular to x-axis, you are getting the circles or the disk of same radius. So such a surface, as we saw, it is nothing but a cylinder. So if I want to find the volume of this cylinder, so what is the first thing I will do? I will find the area of the cross section. So what is the cross sections of the circles? I know what is the formula. Formula is pi r square. In this case, all the radius are fixed. Wherever you drop the plane perpendicular to x-axis, you are getting the circle of same radius. And what is the radius? Radius is 1. So what is the area? Area is pi. And if I integrate, If I want to find the volume, x is from 0 to 5, area of the cross section dx, and what I am getting is answer as 5 pi. So volume of this cylinder, if this cylinder is from 0 to 5, and suppose the radius is 1, so radius is 1 and this is of 5 height, then volume of this cylinder is nothing but 5 pi. And actually you can verify this. You know what is the volume of the cylinder? Pi r square h. H is nothing but the height, which is 5 units, and radius is 1. So pi 1 square into 5, which is nothing but 5 pi. So this is how one can verify their answer if you are getting some standard figure. So let's take another standard figure and then we will go to some non-standard figures. So let's take one more standard figure. So now what is the scenario? If I take y equal to 1 and y equal to minus 1, this is say up to 5 units. Whenever I am dropping the plane perpendicular to x-axis, what I am getting is I am getting the semicircles. So when I am dropping, I am getting the semicircles. If I drop a plane over here perpendicular to x-axis, what I am getting is the, so here is the arc, this is the diameter of that semicircle. So here is the diameter, and what I am getting is I am getting a semicircle over here, and all of them, so my radius is same because this whole thing is the diameter. So this half of this will be the radius. So what I am getting, the same radius. So when I am dropping the plane this perpendicular to x-axis, what I am getting is the semicircle. So in this scenario, if I want to find the volume, so what is the area of the cross section? Area of the cross section, again as I told you, radius is same, radius is 1 unit. So pi into, what is the area of semicircle? Pi r square by 2. So what is the area? Area is pi by 2. And now what is the volume? If I integrate x is from 0 to pi, 0 to 5, pi by 2 dx, and what is the answer? 5 pi by 2. So this is the volume of the, if I cut the cylinder into half, so this is what the volume is. So these are some standard surfaces. Now let's go for the non-standard surface. So in this case, my radius was what? Radius was fixed. Suppose my radius is not fixed. Suppose this is my y equal to x line and this is y equal to minus x line. And let's keep the same scenario. Whenever I'm dropping the plane perpendicular to x-axis, what I'm getting is I'm getting the semicircles. So this is the diameter and here is the semicircle. This is the diameter and this is the semicircle. Here is the diameter and this is the semicircle. So as you can see, the radius of my semicircle is changing. In the previous case, the radius was same. In this case, the radius is changing. So if this was y equal to x, this is y equal to minus x, what is the total distance? Total distance is 2x. So this is the diameter. So how much is the diameter? My diameter is 2x. So what is my radius? Radius is x. So what is area of the cross section? It is nothing but pi r square. So pi x square is the area of each disc. And as you can see, as I am going away from the origin, the radius of the disc is increasing and increasing. Therefore, area has to depend on x. Whereas in the previous two cases, the radius was fixed. So now if I integrate this, suppose this is 0 to 5, x is from 0 to 5, pi x square dx. If I integrate this, I get pi by 3 into 5 cube, which is 125. So 125 by 3 into pi is the volume of this surface. So what is this surface? This is the, it's a kind of dome shape I'm getting over here. If you imagine your ice cream cone, so like if you have this ice cream cone, you cut it into half. So I don't have a good paper right now, but it's kind of the ice cream cone you are having. So if you have the ice cream cone, like this, you simply cut it into half. And what you're getting is this surface, because I'm getting the dome shape over here. So this is nothing but half of the volume of the cone. So answer is 125 pi by 3. You can verify this with the formula of a cone. You remember, you have to divide by 2. So this is how you solve the problems. Let's go something else where you can't imagine the surface. If I take y equal to root of 2 sin x. X is going from 0 to pi, and what is the maximum value? Maximum value is 2. So this is the some curve, and what is the cross sections? The question is, when I'm dropping the plane perpendicular to x axis, what I'm getting are the squares with this as one of the side. So if this is the side, same length is over here, and I'm getting one square. If I'm dropping a plane perpendicular to x axis over here, so this is the square I'm getting. So what I'm getting is the squares. So it's difficult to imagine the surface, but anyways, what I know the cross sections are the squares, and one of the side is this as one of the side. So what is my side? It is nothing but this my y, vertical distance. It is the distance between this point and this point, this point and this point. So what is this? This is y equal to root of 2 sin x, and what is this? This is y equal to 0. So what is the distance? This point minus this point. So this is nothing but 2 root sin x minus 0. So y means vertical distance. So this is my side. So what is the area of the cross section? It is nothing but the side square, because the cross sections are the squares. So I get 2 sin x, and if I want to find the volume, you simply integrate from 0 to pi and you get the answer. So if you do this integration, you get the answer. So it is nothing but, this is nothing but minus 2, what is cos pi minus 1 minus 1, which is nothing but 4. So volume of this surface is 4 unit or 4 cube unit. So this is how you solve the problems if you know the cross sections. Now let's do the cross sections perpendicular to y axis. So let's go for the example where I'm dropping the plane perpendicular to the y axis. So suppose if I take the circle of radius 1, and now what is the scenario? The scenario is, whenever I'm dropping a plane perpendicular to y axis, whenever I'm dropping the plane perpendicular to y axis, what I'm getting is the equilateral triangles with one of the base over here. So this is one of the base of an equilateral triangle, or one of the side, and other two sides are like this. So if I drop a plane over here, this is the equilateral triangle. If I drop a plane over here, this is the equilateral triangle. So I'm getting the equilateral triangles. So this is what the surface is, and the cross sections are equilateral triangle. So since this is the side of the equilateral triangle, so what, this is the distance, right? So what is this? This is my x, horizontal distance. So x equal to square root of 1 minus y square, and this is what, x equal to minus square root of 1 minus y square. So what is this? What is this length? Or if I call this as side, how much is this side? This minus this. If I want to find horizontal distance, we do rightmost point minus the leftmost point. So this minus this is nothing but 2 times root of 1 minus y square. What is area of equilateral triangle? Area of equilateral triangle is root 3 by 4 into side square, which is nothing but 2 root 1 minus y square, which is root 3 into. So this is the area of that equilateral triangle. So as you know that, as you can see, this area of the equilateral triangle will depend on the cross sections where I'm dropping. If I'm dropping over here, I get a smaller equilateral triangle. If I drop over here, I get a bigger equilateral triangle. Therefore, your area will depend on y. And if I want to find the volume of this surface, you simply integrate y from minus 1 to minus 1, because this is my restriction, right? So I can go from minus 1 to 1, root 3 1 minus y square dy, and what I get is some number. This number is nothing but volume of the surface. So whenever a surface is given to you and the cross sections are given to you, find the area of that cross sections. Once you have the area of the cross section, you simply integrate, you get the volume. So I hope this is helpful. In the next lecture, we will see how disk method help us to find the volume. So I hope this is clear. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you.